For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful,
Counselor,
the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father,
the Prince of Peace.
Now the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child by the Holy Spirit. And Joseph, her husband, being a righteous man, and not wanting to disgrace her, desired to put her away secretly. But when he had considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for that which has been conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bear a son, and you will call his name Jesus, for it is he who will save his people from their sins. And Joseph arose from his sleep and did as the angel of the Lord commanded him.
Once in every life, that someone special comes along the way. Now I know we're right. An angel came to me and made my eyes to see that God has given you to marry me. Mary, I don't understand it all. Why God would choose my name to call? I'm just a man, a simple man, a carpenter, but part of God's plan. Doubt once filled my mind. Would something that's so right be torn apart? Now, since the angel came, my eyes can clearly see that you're still meant for me, and God has planned our place in history. Mary, I don't understand it all. Why God would choose my name to call? I'm just a man, a simple man, a carpenter, but part of God's plan. A carpenter, but part of God's plan. Now
all this took place, that what was spoken by the Lord through the prophet might be fulfilled, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, and shall bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us.
Before the world began, together we'll be one, wherever you may go.
our home this day. Our God, we will obey, and He will lead us from the troubled times that darkest night, the Lord will be our light,
and we'll go on together, walk together, bound by our love from God.
About this time, Caesar Augustus, the Roman Emperor, decreed that a census should be taken throughout the nation. Everyone was required to return to his ancestral home for this registration. And because Joseph was a member of the royal line, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, King David's ancient home, journeying there from the Galilean village of Nazareth. And he took Mary with him, who was obviously pregnant by this time. While they were there, the time came for her baby to be born, and she gave birth to her first child, a son.
Upon his shoulder, and him.
wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Mary was filled with a deep joy as in her arms she held the Savior of the world, God's gift of love. That night, some shepherds were in the fields outside the village, guarding their flock of sheep. Suddenly, an angel appeared among them, and the landscape shone bright with the glory of the Lord.
On the town was fast asleep. Shepherds watched their flock of sheep in the field near Bethlehem. Where they suddenly they saw a light.
Don't be afraid, the angel said. I bring you the most joyful news ever announced, and it is for everyone. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born tonight in Bethlehem. How will you know him? You will find a baby wrapped in a blanket, lying in a manger. Great army of angels had returned again to heaven. The shepherds said to each other, "Come on, let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this wonderful thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." Returned to their fields and flocks, praising God for the visit of the angels. They told everyone what had happened, what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story expressed astonishment. But Mary quietly treasured these things in her heart and often thought about them. Following the birth of Jesus in Bethlehem, some wise men arrived in Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him."
Eastern wise men from afar, following a distant guiding star, over miles of soon before the Savior they will stand, which the kings for him prepare, frankincense and myrrh so rare. This with precious gold they'll share when they
Savior's face. Break a love to Him they bring, as they kneel before and worship Him.
The wise men returned to their homes with great joy, knowing that they had found the king who would someday rule, and rule over a world at peace. That's the promise of the Christmas story. But until the Prince of Peace reigns, another kind of peace is available to all who now trust him. Remember his words, "I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart." And the peace I give isn't fragile like the peace the world gives. So don't be troubled or afraid.
Problems overwhelm.
Do you have this peace? Do you know the Prince of Peace? Does Christmas have a significance for you beyond toys and tinsel? If not, I invite you to believe as did the shepherds and wise men of old. Believe and receive Jesus as your own Lord and Savior. For as the scripture says, but as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, even to those who believed in his name.
Government.